Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to place any graphic or text at the bottom of a crystal clear swimming pool. Notice how the graphic conforms to the contours of the water and how the water's surface reflections remain bright and intact. This is an update of a tutorial I did many years ago on an earlier version of Photoshop. I provided this image of a swimming pool so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files. Its size is 1920 by 1080 pixels and a resolution of 72 pixels per inch. I also provided this water park logo for your convenience. Feel free to replace it with a different graphic, however, make sure your graphic is relatively sharp with dimensions approximately this size, including its resolution. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to my channel, click that small subscribe button at the lower right corner. The first step is to separate the graphic from the background. If the background is a solid color, as in this example, open your magic wand tool. Make its tolerance 10 pixels, and make sure contiguous is checked. Contiguous ensures that similar colors inside the graphic won't be selected. Click anywhere on the background to select it. If you need to select other areas of the background, shift-click those areas to include them as well. To check your selection, press Q on your keyboard to see it as a quick mask. Then, revert it back into a selection by pressing Q again. Click the lock icon on the right side of the layer to unlock it. Then, press the delete key on your keyboard to delete the background. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. To place the graphic onto the swimming pool, press V on your keyboard to open your Move tool. Drag the graphic onto the tab of the swimming pool. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. If you need to resize the graphic, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. Then press Enter or Return. To center it, press Ctrl or Command A to select the pool and click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then deselect it. We'll move the graphic down by pressing and holding the Shift key and pressing the down arrow on your keyboard a few times. The reason we're doing this is because our graphic will appear centered once we angle our entire image in perspective. In addition, we'll move the graphic 30 pixels to the left by pressing and holding the Shift key as you press the left arrow 3 times. We're doing this since the displacement map that we'll be using later will displace our graphic 30 pixels the opposite way to the right. Next, we'll make a displacement map of the swimming pool, which we'll use to warp our graphic to the contours of the water. To do this, first, we'll duplicate the water layer by making it active and clicking the icon at the upper right. Click Duplicate Layer. Open the document list, click New, and name it Displacement. Then click OK. A duplicate of the swimming pool image was instantly created. We'll use this duplicate for our displacement map. Since displacement maps work best when they're slightly blurred, go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur 3 or 4 pixels. Go to File, and Save As. Choose your desktop so you can find it easily. Save it as a Photoshop PSD document and click Save. Since it's now saved onto our desktop, we can close the document. Next, we'll save the graphic as a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively, as well as replace it with a different graphic or text without having to redo any of the effects. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 2 pixels. go back to Filter, Distort, and Displace. Type in 30 in the horizontal and vertical scales, since we slid our graphic 30 pixels to the left. However, keep in mind, the higher the scale number, the more displaced our graphic will look. Depending on the complexity of your graphic, you may want to displace it at a lower scale, such as 10 or 20, otherwise your graphic may look too distorted. Tick Stretch to Fit and repeat Edge Pixels. Click the displacement document you saved and click Open. Instantly, our graphic has been warped to the contours of the water. Next, we'll make our graphic appear to be on the bottom of the pool. Let's close the effects to save space in the Layers panel. Change the Blend Mode to Lighten and reduce the opacity to 40%. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Change its Blend Mode to Overlay and reduce its opacity to 70%. Next, we'll angle our entire image in perspective. To do this, place all three layers into a folder by clicking off the lock icon to unlock the water and shift-clicking the top layer to make all the layers active. Then, press Ctrl or Command G to place them into a folder. To place your image in perspective, we need more room around our image. Zoom out of your document by pressing Ctrl or Command and the minus key in your keyboard twice. Go to Edit, Transform, and Perspective. If you see this message, it's just letting us know that the effects we added will be temporarily turned off while we use the Transform tool. Just click OK. Go to a bottom corner and drag it out until your image is at a perspective you like. Then press Enter or Return. To zoom back in, press Ctrl or Command and the plus key on your keyboard. Lastly, let's brighten our image. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Levels. In the Input Midtone field, type in 0.90 and in the Input Highlight field, type in 220. If you want to replace your graphic with text, open the folder and double-click any smart object to open its source image. Make a new layer and hide the graphic. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a font. I find that heavier weights for this effect tend to have the best results. I'll use a size of approximately 410 points, so it's large enough to see. However, once it's typed out, I'll be adjusting the size to fit the document. Choose Center Alignment and black for its color. Click on the center of the document and type out your text. To adjust its size, highlight all the text and place your cursor over the size icon. Drag it to the right or left. Open your Move tool, close the text document, and when you see this message, just click Yes to replace the graphic with the text. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.